that you do with the deck or pack saddle. One is a barrel sling and one's a basket sling. When you put your ropes up, you put them up depending upon what type of sling you think you'll use next. So if we were going to use a barrel sling,
how many feet of rope do you use?
How many feet of rope? Anybody want to know how long a sling rope is?
How long it started as?
No, how long one is. How long a sling rope is. This 33 and a third feet. That's how long they are.
I thought it was going to be a joke.
Why would it be 33 and a third? There is a key to that.
That was my question.
Start with 100 foot.
You start with 100 foot and it cuts into three rows. Anywhere 30 to 35 feet is adequate. You don't really need any more than that. If you're doing cargo ropes, 45 feet is pretty good. I've got some 55 footers and I've probably got some 40 footers depending on what we're doing, but standard 40 to 45 feet. So let's just quick show you what a barrel sling is going to be. Pretty simple. That's a barrel. It's just two loops. Can you see anything that you want to pack parallel to the mule or to your pack animal, you're going to pack this in a barrel sling. And that's what it is. So how do I put my rope up right now in order to make sure that that's easy to get to? I make one loop behind my D-ring right there. And then I just make a bunch of loops. Until I get to where I want it to be, go ahead and just bring this rope around and tuck it back through itself. I probably do it a couple times, and then it's going to be there. Now when I undo it, if I'm going to a barrel sling, if I pull on my loose end of my rope here,
you have the one on.
I reach right here, into a barrel. The basket, which is, you do just the opposite. Okay, this one I brought through and that. This one I'm bringing this way. Is that a basket sling? Guys are watching this because this will be on the test, the final. A basket sling is simply that right there. What I've done is I've got it right here. Whatever I put in, and it's going to be things I want to pack perpendicular to the mule. For you elk hunters, listen to this. Hind quarters, barrel sling. Front quarters, basket. And that's what's going to hold them. But what I do is I put whatever, and this rope right here that's going to go around this part, it's actually the rope that's going to tighten. This rope simply to hold the weight from dropping out the bottom. But this is really where your tension and your hold is. If you've ever nailed a board on the wall, and you make sure you don't hold it from the bottom, you hold it up where you're going to nail and put a lot of tension there, and then you pound your nail in. Same principle. So that there. And we'll get to that, but so if I'm putting this rope up for that, I take all my slack out here and make my loops. Right? Now we can do it up, but as I undo it, guess what? As I pull my slack out, I've got my basket already. So that you put your ropes up dependent. This is a principle of decker packing. Is it, when I say slings, what's the difference between a sling and a panniard? Why would we use something in a sling rather than putting a panniard on here, putting a
something
bigger,
bulkier? Yeah, exactly. The other thing is guess what? If we're going along and it hits a tree, it's a sling. It's going to allow it to push out of the way, swing back in. So it's got that sling motion. And so it's a lot easier on the animal than if they hit a tree with something that's really lash cinched down to them, they take that brunt. They're going to be pushed out of the way rather than having the load moved out of the way. So that's part of the key to the Decker system. Why they developed a Decker system is because of those rigid objects that they were packing and so forth. They didn't want them constantly beating on their animals. They put a half breed and a sideboard in. They learned how to sling their loads to allow for movement of the load rather than movement of the animal.